Hello there, and welcome to Euro Truck Simulator 2 with me, Stockoglaws, as it says on the side of my cab. How you doing? Right, we're going to start another job. Where are we? We've got no petrol, I can remember that much. We've got 41 grand in the bank, so we need a bit more money before we can buy another driver. But in the last 7 days, we've made over 100 grand, which is awesome. So let's see where we're going to go. We are in... we're in Italy, yes, we're in Verona. And thank you for the comments about the song that was in my head but wasn't. And that was My Sharona, yes. I actually played that on iTunes when I finished. Okay, so from Verona, where are we going to go? We can go back into Germany. We can go to Brno again. Zurich. We haven't been to Switzerland yet, so... That is going to be a good shout, I think, going into Zurich. We've done Austria. We haven't been to France, so... Well, we have, but not only Calais. So it'll be quite nice. But I think we're going to go to Zurich. We're going to go into Switzerland, and then hopefully France, back into the UK, and try and keep doing a... We haven't done anything in Slovakia yet. Is that Slovakia? Yeah, Bratislava. And Germany is massive, so we need to do quite a bit in Germany. And you can't go to the bottom end of Italy, it's just the top end. Yeah, I wish they did, like, sort of release the patches or, you know, an add-on to release the rest of Europe. You know, going down into Spain and stuff, that'd be pretty cool. But anyway, so this is what we're going to do, guys. We're going to go to Zurich. Let's set GPS destination. And it's raining. Typical. Right, let's start them up. We need fuel, pretty bad. So, where do we find fuel? Hey, do we need to sleep? Let's have a look. Next rest, yeah. Oh, we're gonna lose Zurich if I rest. And where am I going? Am I going the wrong way? Yes, I'm going the wrong way. I don't want to lose Zurich. Am I going the wrong way? Oh my god, I am so confused. That's it. IKEA! So we need fuel and we need to rest. I can see where we can rest. No, I do not enter the job offer. Where are we going, guys? We have to. Yeah. Let's turn left here. Whoa! Wow, that was very close. But I didn't hit him. I did not hit. There's another car. Oh my god, come on. I didn't hit him. Oh my god, this is a great start to the episode. Hey, welcome to... Oh, that's just a garage we can buy, isn't it? Welcome to Stockoglaws Failure. Come in here, we're going to rest, choose another job, and find some fuel. There we go. Okay, press the following key to stop the engine. Follow the key to stop the engine. E. Press enter to rest, and we are getting some rest. Looks like we're going to have to find another job. It's finished raining, thank God. It's light. Great. Let's see what's in the job market. Come on. Give us a good one. I want to go to Switzerland now. We are in... Is that Manchester to Manchester? For 722 quid. Wow. That is going to be the shortest journey ever. £98 a mile. Brilliant. Okay, we're in Verona. Where are we going? We've got Strasbourg. We've got Dijon. Mannheim. Strasbourg. Back up to Brno. So we're going to go France in, guys. Dijon or Strasbourg? Good Dijon, I think. No, go Strasbourg. We go Strasbourg. That's what we're doing. Asco Nobel. So, set that as GPS. Let's go to Strasbourg. Right, we got 269 miles in our tank. Let's turn the windscreen wipers off. Let's go pick up our load. We're going to go into France. I'm a bit gutted we didn't manage to get into wherever we was going. I've forgotten now. There we go. That was better. That was better. Come on, flower. We got right away. Come on. Move. Let's go. Ugh. You do actually use more fuel, you know, city driving than you do actually on the motorway, so I've got to be a little bit careful with my fuel. Although, if I burn 269 miles driving around the city, then there's something wrong with me. Okay, that's green. This is going to be, again, another boring episode. You're not going to see any crashes, any speeding offences. You're going to see some awesome driving. And that car just stopped. I swear the AI in this game hates me. And I've gone the wrong way. I should have... There's me saying, if I do 269 miles in the city and shoot me, and I just went straight past the place I need to pick up my load. So we need to do an emergency... Yui in a minute. Hopefully there'll be no cars coming up on the inside. This is highly illegal, but I shouldn't get fined for it. I'm hoping the police sympathise with my situation. Yeah, nobody noticed. Nobody noticed. That was a textbook 3-point turn. And it's green lights, which means they approve of my 3-point turn. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So I'm going to pop into Audi now and pick up our load after this car. Oh, he's flashing me. Thank you, Flower. You're a gentleman and a scholar. Let's go. Enter. We are going to Strasbourg. Take the job. Head towards the green flag. Yes, sir. So, yes, never been to Strasbourg. I've driven to the south of France, but it was at night time, and I didn't see much. Didn't see much stuff. It was just dark, traffic lights, toll bridges. That's what I can remember about France. There's a lot of toll bridges. Right, reverse, reverse, come on. There we go. Okay, I don't like that view. Sorry if you can hear the dog in the background. She's been really noisy lately. Like, keep barking all the time. We had kind of a snow last night and let the dog out this morning. And she's never seen snow or really bad frost that we've been having. And so funny, she didn't want to go outside for... you know, to do a business or whatever. And it was hilarious to see the dog trying to walk on snow. You know, trying to lift her feet up and... Oh, I should have recorded it, really. I'd have had like 10,000 views easy. funny dog. Yeah, but she's a pain in the ass. I love her a bit, but she's a pain. Keeps barking all the time. And when you go and say, like, What's wrong? Somebody's stuck in a well? You know, somebody's stuck in a cave. Come on, I'll follow you. She, you know, sort of bites your clothes. I don't think she's very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? Intelligent. She, I can hear beeping. Oh, hang on. Yeah, the wife's cooking. I'm in the wrong side of the road. The wife's cooking, that's the fire alarm. Yeah, it goes off quite a lot. And to be fair, the wife, this is her excuse, is that the fire alarm is above the kitchen door. And it's not because it's a fire that it's going off, it's because it's they can feel the heat of the oven door when she opens the oven door. So that's what she keeps telling me. But I can remember I used to play EVE Online quite a lot and talk to people from all over the world. On TeamSpeak, and it's quite funny because as we're talking, they hear this beeping sound in the background, and they're like, "Oh, your tea's ready, Stocko." And I was like, "Oh, right, okay, thanks." Yeah. Oh, screen. I thought I'd share that with you. That conversation seemed to go a bit weird from like calling my dog dumb and taking a mick out of my wife's cooking. But sorry, she don't watch my videos, so. As long as you guys don't tell her, I won't be in the doghouse. Alright, on we go to Strasbourg. We need a petrol station, or gas station, or no, I think that's all we call them around the world, isn't it? Petrol and gas. We could call them other things. Service station. Oh, that was a good turning, that was. I'm proud of that one. Did you see that? Of course you've seen it. Is this a toll road? They do gas. How much is this going to cost me then? Oh, let's go forward a little bit. Start of toll road. Keep the ticket. Ah, okay. This one's free. Thank you. See you again. Actually, abroad, because a lot of the toll booths then would be on the left-hand side, so you'd have to sort of climb over your cab just to get the ticket. Yeah. Unless they man on both sides in case, like, a strange English person or British person comes through. I doubt it, because they wouldn't be very busy. I'm sure there'd be more Europeans than Brits going through the toll booths. As you can see, I'm probably overtired. I talk a lot when I'm overtired, and work is just insane at the moment. I've been on... Well, it's not work. Well, it is work, but it isn't. Let me explain. I've got a lot of like Christmas parties that I go to, like some of my customers, and like networking and that type of thing. So it's just like crazy that they're all trying to have a piece of the Stocko, and I'm going to have to spread myself really thin, you know, after work activities like bowling and just going down the pub and going for meals and things like that. I actually went bowling, 10-pin bowling last night, and yeah, you're not going to say I'm rubbish, but I was quite pleased with my score, to be honest. We had two games, and I managed to get 111 in the first game and 115 in the second. And in between the two games, I must have had about 3 or 4 pints. So, if I had 10 pints, I probably would have broke into the 120 mark. But I had work the next day, obviously, and driving at this time of year, you've got to be really, really careful. So, I'm going to have to cut you up, sorry, slow down. There we go. Going to go into this lane. What road's this? This is the Milano-Torino road. Beautiful. Oh yeah, because we are in Italy, aren't we? I forgot. The lovely Italian countryside there. We have to slow down just a tad. I think my drive is a lot better with a lower-powered engine. I think having a high-powered engine is harder than it actually looks. And I've seen somebody leave a message saying, "Stocko, bought the game because you played it, loved it. By the way, how hard is this game?" I suppose I make it look easy, you know, because I'm pro, and yeah, sorry about that. I'm not that pro. But there is a petrol station coming up just when we need it. We've got 127 miles in the tank. And we're going to go in. Fill up on juice. And gin. Whoa, what was that? Okay, loan installments of just under $6,000. Wow. And this is going to cost us a pretty penny as well. Whoa. Okay, E to stop. Hold down enter. How much is a litre here? €1.48. Actually, it's about £1.40 in GBP at the moment, a litre diesel. So it's fairly expensive. Ultimate. That's BP, isn't it? Ultimate, I think. Are we in a BP one? I don't know. Oh! Nearly $2,000. Wow. Okay. Well, what was that for? Oh, just pay for it. I keep panicking until I hear that sound. It's like, oh no, what have I done? Because this is going to be a fairly boring one today. We're not going to have any problems of speed. I can't see, let's hope. Okay. Any problems with speeding, crashing, it's just going to be fairly mundane. Nice drive, you know, through Italy, into France. Actually, when I drove down to the south of France, we went to Saint-Tropez. Oh, amazing. Absolutely fantastic. It was one of the best holidays I've ever had. And we went out. We were staying in this caravan park right on the coast. And I said to the missus, I said, I was going to pop out and get some chips or something, a takeaway. And I forgot the sat-nav. You just pull out in front of me then. Just polite, it's fine, honestly. I forgot the sat nav, and it was only popping into the little town. Well, me and my mate, we drove into this little town, and the shop was shut. So we said, well, let's just go to the nearest town. So we went to the nearest town. 2.5 hours later, we got lost. We ended up on the Italian border. We needed to come back home. So, and we forgot our mobile phone. And the wife was panicking. She was in a right mess when we got back. She was crying, and she said I was going to ring the police. And yeah, it was hilarious on our point of view. But every time I bring it up, she kind of slaps me, and you know, around the arm, and says, "Don't ever do that to me again." Yeah, so don't bring it up in front of her anymore. The bruises and stuff. But yeah, it's a funny little thing that happened to me. Things like that always. Oh my God, what happened there? Okay, I must have been speeding. I was going to say, things that happen to me quite a lot. See, that's me telling you stories and stuff, you know. This is just, I need to concentrate on driving. Well, that bus is a bit all over the shop. Maybe it was a dodgy bit of road. I think, yeah, that's what it was. It was a dodgy bit of road. We hit a bit of black ice there. You know, that bus hit it. We hit it. Yeah. That's what I'm putting it down to. You know, normally I'm a very, very good driver. You know, we've been in a trucker now for a while. We've done nearly 1,500 miles together. Bit of black ice, and we're... I was lucky. You know, as you can see, it looks like it's been a bit frosty. It's around about minus three at the moment. Okay, don't look down at my dashboard where it says 25 degrees Celsius, because it's just lying. It's a bit of a malfunction of the temperature probe for the car. Yes, I'm overtired and I talk a lot. I know. That's the whole point, isn't it, of doing a Let's Play? You know, you don't want somebody there who just doesn't talk and, you know. Oh, look, a white car. But yeah. Okay, calm down, Stocko. I haven't drank that much either today. Normally I have like a couple of, you know, cups of tea and today I haven't drank that much. And I haven't got anything on tonight, hence the reason why I'm recording, which is fantastic. But yeah. I appreciate all your patiences, if that's a word. Plural of patience. let's slow down. Is this a tow road? Yep. Carty. Stop! Oh my god. I tell you what, these AI cars have got it in for me. He didn't pay. He did not stop and press enter. He didn't. They just opened the barrier. I've seen that. He didn't stop at this green mark, like this, and press enter. He didn't do it. Cheats. Yeah, the missus has got a few of her girly friends around tonight, and whenever, like, I'm not a big fish eater, alright? I know, I should eat more fish, it's good for you know, omega 6 or whatever it is, I don't know. I'm not a big fish eater, but the missus loves fish. She eats crab sticks, you know? Who eats crab sticks, really? And, so she's got her girly friends coming around, and she always says, like, oh, when they come round, we'll have fish. The whole house stinks of fish. Oh, it's disgusting. When I say I don't eat fish, you know, I quite like prawns. But they got to be cooked. Now, we got this bit of an argument, me and the missus, about... Wow, this episode's really a lot about my wife, isn't it? I apologise for that. I've got an argument against, you know, a mate at the pub about prawns. this is better. And when you buy uncooked prawns, they're kind of like clear, aren't they? You know, they're like see-through-ish. And when you buy cooked prawns, they're... Oh, this is going a bit quick. They're pink. But I don't like them cold. I like them what I call cooked, like warm prawns. I don't like cold cooked prawns. If that makes any sense. I'm a bit weird. Like, oh, we're in the wrong lane. I'm a bit weird like that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, so we had a prawn cocktail the other day, and she had to cook the prawns, like, again, even though the cooked prawns, again. Do you know what? Even I am boring myself talking at the moment, so I apologise for that. What else has been going on? That's another toll road? Wow. God. They're like buses, aren't they? You know, you wait all day for a toll road and then two come along on the same day. Okay. £7. Okay. Wasn't really worth me stopping, was it? Yeah, to be honest, $7. Okay, let's go. Off to Strasbourg. We've got a full tank of gas. We're not going to actually make any money on this journey after paying our loan instalments and all these tolls on our way. Are we actually in France yet? Let's check our map. Where are we? There's Milano. No, we're just coming in. Actually, it's quite hard to see. Dijon, I think. Yeah, there's Strasbourg over there. So we go in. That's where we're ending up. I don't think we're in France yet, but we've explored like nearly 20% of the map. That's pretty awesome. I don't know how long I'll be keeping this LP up for, until you guys get bored, or if I carry on talking the rubbish I'm talking, I'm sure, you know, you guys won't be watching it anymore, and it'll kind of stop itself, I suppose. But we're on the A9. We've got six hours to go. Wow, I could do a lot of talking in 6 hours. 236 miles away. We're doing some long distance stuff at the moment. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I bet Oscar's going to take that Manchester to Manchester job, isn't he? He's going to drive from Birmingham all the way up to Manchester and just deliver in Manchester. Or Manchester. However you say it. Yeah, Oscar needs to pull his finger out. Yeah, he's part of the team. He's part of the company. You know, I said before, he's married to my sister. Right, this is Italy, and we're going into... rubbish. Switzerland. Oh, you lot are going to rip me a new one. Ah, it is Switzerland because it's the Swiss knife, army knife. It's got the same logo. So, yeah, check my geography out. Or my knowledge of army knives, which I only know one, which is the Swiss one. So, yeah. and I used to have an army knife, a Swiss army knife, when I was a scout. Yeah, I was a scout, yeah. Yeah, we used to go camping and stuff, and white water rafting, and rock climbing. Got my rock climber's badge, yeah. But I grew up and decided not to do it anymore. I think I found alcohol, and that kind of took over my life for a while, and girls, and cars, you know, the normal thing you do when you get older. Oh, we better slow down, it's 50 now. So yes, I don't know where I'm going with that. And I'm sharing quite a lot with you tonight. It's quite a personal episode. Why am I slowing down? Come on, let's go. Drop a gear. Oh, look at that scenery, eh? The Swiss Alps. Isn't like Switzerland supposed to be a little bit cold, a bit snowy? It's near the Alps, isn't it? The border between Italy and Switzerland. According to this, it's 25 degrees still. I haven't actually noticed in any of the other episodes what if the actual temperature gauge goes up or down. It might have been 25 degrees C in Poland and in the other countries we've been to. Well, it was -3 this morning. It was absolutely freezing. -3 when I got in the car. Now, I know some of you are going to go, hey, that ain't cold, you know, it's like -432 here in wherever. But, you know, you kind of get like climatized to where, you know, what you're used to. And I'm not used to -3. That's a bit cold for me. But then again, us Brits moan about everything. So, you know, if it's like 32 degrees C as well, we're like, oh my God, it's too hot. Turn it down. Sun, go away. Well, most of us do anyway. Yeah, we're just never happy. That's the end of the day. We're just never happy. Oh, I can't go in that lane. These roads, like, layouts change quite often, don't they? Depending on where you are and, like, what country you're in. Which is pretty funky. Adds that sort of realism. Got some parking where we can sleep. We don't need to sleep just yet. We're okay. We slept before we took the job. We've got plenty of miles in the tank. It's a lovely day, and it hasn't rained either. You know, during this journey, it's been nice and sunny. A solid 25 degrees C. 25 degrees C. This looks a bit of a weird bend. I had to brake there a little bit. My confidence was knocked on that little black ice slide that we did back in Italy. We're in a 50 mile an hour tunnel. I like going through tunnels. I think everybody does, you know. It's a fun thing to do, isn't it? I bet those big yellow lines, arrows, aren't there in real life. Got a bit of a cold as well. If you can hear me sniffing, I apologise. I'm always bloody ill in this weather. When it gets cold like this, I'm always ill. I'm one of these sicky people, you know. I tried to soldier on though, and not tell anybody about it, and just, you know, apart from the missus, because she does more for me when I'm not very well. Oh my God, what's going on? This is new. You got roadworks, and I just pushed right in. I love it. Hey, this is new. I haven't seen the roadworks like this before. This is like properly. This is done. Awesome. Oh wow. Do you know what? I really like that. That's a great touch. They should do more of that. Yeah. Still loving the cab. Thank you very much, Adam, for doing the skin on the cab. Brilliant. You'll have to put a little link on the Facebook page if anybody else wants to download the cab for their Euro Truck Simulator. Yeah, my upload schedule is a bit messed up at the moment. My apologies. It's going to Christmas. But during the Christmas break, I've got loads of time for myself, so you should have quite a few videos. And maybe some live streams as well. Now, I know this is going to probably upset a lot of you. I love my sim games. You know, you guys know I do. I play the sim games to the best of my ability. But I've been playing a lot of Minecraft, you know. Well, when I say playing a lot of Minecraft, I'm at work. I shouldn't probably be saying this because I know a few people at work watch my videos. But, I do play quite a bit of Minecraft at work. And it's amazing. Yeah, really got into it. You know, like Minecraft, you get bored of it, and then you have like a big break, and then you get into it again, and it catches you like it did the first, you know, the first day you turned it on, and started like going, oh my god, I could break a tree with my fist. Yeah, it's kind of got me like that a little bit. But don't worry, it's not going to affect my upload schedule. When I'm home, I'm on my gaming computer, it's Farming Sim, this, and my showcases, so don't worry. Don't go all emo rage in the comments about me playing Minecraft. Yes, so I just thought I'd let you know. The new Feed the Beast mod, brilliant. Check it out. You must download it. Absolutely fantastic. I love all the technical... Like, I know some of you have been saying this right from the start, like, hey, check out the ticket model, check out this, check out that. And I was like, yeah, you know, not really into my Minecraft that much. You know, there's millions of videos on Minecraft on YouTube. I'll watch a few every now and then. But when I actually sort of started playing it, installed all the mods, oh, wow, it caught me. It done me like a kipper. So if you've you know, had enough of Minecraft and haven't played it for a while, and just have a little look at Feed the Beast, and you'll be pleasantly surprised, I'm sure. Anyway, enough of Minecraft. Before some of you decide to go mad and delete my channel or something. Omzi Bus Simulator, I think that's how it. No, is it Omni or Omzi? I don't know. I've had a look. I will get that over the Christmas break. And it's raining. And we will showcase that and have a look at some bus simulator. And also, as I said, my one of my videos showcase. I think the train sim. I think about the Flight Simulator X and Air Hauler. I will have a look at that as well. So I've got plenty of ideas and plenty of games I want to showcase with you guys. And keep playing. Whoa! Oh my god, a bit of black ice yet again. Why does it keep doing that? Why does it keep doing that? I didn't take that corner very fast. I didn't take it hard. It's every time I have this trailer, it doesn't quite work for me. I think I need... I know what's going to be in the comments. You need an extra axle. I think I do. But I'm not high enough level yet. I don't want to cheat and just get it. You know, I want to do it properly. Oh my god! What is going on? Oh, just cut that car up, sorry. But you know what? Ironically, I haven't crashed or anything yet. And we've had, what, 3 or 4 skids. Big black lines going down the centre of the road. Oh, this is weird. Stop bouncing. Yeah, nobody mentioned the physics mod in the previous episode. I think one person did, went, get rid of it. And then somebody said, have you still got the physics mod on? So, I can see you guys getting used to it about as much as I am. It's just good. Because it is kind of realistic, I suppose. But every time we take one of these trailers, you know, the heavy container trailers. Well, I haven't got a very powerful engine anymore. Maybe my turning's a bit erratic, or if that's a word, I don't know. I'm from Gloucester and I put a lot of R's in words and make words up with an R in it. It just sounds right, doesn't it? Yeah, it's a little bit of a worry. Might need to have a look at my settings and maybe reduce my sensitivity. It's a big word, like marmalade, on my control box, my Xbox 360 controller. So I can't have me skidding like that, losing control every so often. That's kind of off-putting. But at the moment, I'm playing with the lights off in the, you know, in my room, in my office, and it's actually pretty cool because it kind of looks realistic a little bit, as much as it can do. And it really scares me, you know, when I skid off like that or get close to crashing, it really stop breaking. Kind of scares me. Now we need to get this lane. And the rain doesn't help either. It makes everything look dark and gloomy. Oh, look at it! Look at the look at the temperature, guys. You haven't been keeping an eye on it, have you? You haven't. Look at it. It's 16 degrees Celsius. So it does go up and down. Ah, right, good. Come on, that's a Volkswagen Golf in front, isn't it? There we go. We're on the number three, red three. It sounds like I'm doing the bingo results. Yes, red three. I don't think we've crossed the border into France as yet. Okay, that's doing my head in. This is going to be a long tunnel. Nope, it's going to finish now. Typical. Oh, talk about France. This is, yes, we're in France. We are in France now, in Europe. Beautiful. So we can stop over and get some frog legs and, paintings. Champagne, yeah, champagne's French. Champagne are very well known for their food, you know. Just trying to think of something apart from French legs at the moment, but it's not really coming to me. Yeah, let's talk about something else. What's that for? Oh, income. Oh, wow. Nearly $4,000 from Oscar. You are a diamond. That's not bad, is it, eh? We might have actually break even this trip. It'd be quite nice, wouldn't it? Whoa, Banksy, Banksy, Banksy. Come on, calm down, calm down. Come on, Laurie. What a... Now we're on the A36. It's terrible weather, isn't it, for trucking? I don't know if they've got a game, Ice Road Truckers. I don't know if there's a game with that. But that is some scary stuff. Can you imagine, you know, carrying these massive loads to the quarries and the mining places in the middle of like Alaska or North America, Canada, I guess, places. I just hear in the ground like sort of creak as you go over the top of it, and you know that if you fell in, there's a very good chance you're gonna die. Talk about danger money. No thanks. You just put me in a cab in the middle of Italy or France, where, you know, a little bit of rain, it's a bit of a pain, but it's 15 degrees, I'm fairly happy with that. Now, I need to turn left in a minute, well, now, not in a minute, Let's go left to Metz and Rhymes. Well, you see me pull out car. Why don't you just carry on pulling out, you clonk? Oh well. I think the AI hates me. I think the AI hates me with a passion. Well, we're less than an hour away. We're 32 miles away from Strasbourg. Unfortunately, we can't see the French countryside, the beautiful French countryside, because of the rain. Stuttgart is to the right. Well, we're going to go straight on. Stuttgart, I think that's German. Germany, isn't it? Stuttgart sounds German. I say my European geography isn't the best. I don't claim to be a geography teacher or a history teacher. I'm pretty rubbish at the history. I know Henry VIII had loads of wives. Anne Boleyn was one of them, and he chopped her head off. Yeah, you're learning some English history here, guys. It's more than just a let's play of Euro Truck Simulator 2. ...1066, the Battle of Hastings. Yeah, that was a big one. I think somebody got shot in the eye around that sort of period. Somebody quite... King Richard, was it? Somebody. Yeah, now it's starting to get a bit phasey. Yeah, it's been a while since I did a history at school. But I tell you what, I've always really enjoyed... the Egyptian history. That kind of really... excites me. Well, you know, I'm interested. I wouldn't say I'm excited about it. You'd all be glad to know that we're nearly there. Yeah, and my jibber jabbering is finally nearly coming to an end. And we didn't crash. Oh, we've got a turn right here. Overshot it. Oh, there's a car right at my bum. Come on. There we go. That's a nice clear run there, guys. Not one crash, not one speeding ticket, not one fine. A boring, excellent video. Apart from me talking about stuff. I promise I'll try and tone it down next episode. And talk about more important things like... important stuff. Okay. Yeah, we don't want to go too fast on this road. It looks fairly bumpy and gravel. Where are we going? This looks like a scene of like a horror movie. You know, where it's dark and it's raining and it's thundering, the lightning and the lonely English truck driver pulls in at Strasbourg Quarry, looking to drop off his load. Finds the Strasbourg Quarry Reaper ready and waiting to pounce at any time. No, don't worry, I don't mean to scare you. It's not Halloween or anything, it's just a game, guys. Don't worry. I'm not really sitting in this cab driving this big truck. I can't see. There it is. That big white thing. Flashing arrow. That's where we need to go. Well, that is going to be fairly easy to park. I might park it for some extra XP. What do you reckon? I get in trouble, I can always press enter before I crash. Looking good. Looking good. Oh, stop the screen. Press T.
Yes, job completed. Excellent.
We've driven 363 miles. It's taken us just under 9 hours. Wow. Fuel consumed. Yes, we know. Base reward, 12 grand plus 1.5 plus 1.7. Bonus for parking the trailer, an extra 45 experience. Yes, and we leveled up. We're still an enthusiast though. That's no good. Come on. What we're going to do now, guys, we're going to go... I think we're going to... I want to sort of do this, but also that is going to be... You can save up to 10% of our fuel with a trailer and without a trailer. So that'd be fairly good, but I might go that one. Just because you get some decent stuff, you know, that's probably better. Is that more corrosive? Is that like, you know, corrosive, dissolve organic tissue? Yeah, that sounds pretty cool. Let's get Stocko in charge of corrosive substances. That sounds like a plan. Well, here we go. Well, guys, this is the end of the episode. Oh, we got new upgrades available. Let's check them out quickly. With Scania, we can have front wheels, Eastern Eagle. Lovely. Rear wheels, Eastern Eagle. Okay. I thought that. No, that's not the wheels. That's the wheels there. We're looking at paint main mirrors. For the man, Daff. Oh, right. Okay. Well, guys, this is Euro Truck Simulator 2. We've got 50,000 pounds now. We're getting close to our target where we could buy another truck. Might have to visit Mr. Bank Manager. What we got here? We've got 360 left to pay. We can borrow another 100,000, so we might visit that next episode and get another guy on the books. Give Oscar somebody to talk to. But yes, thank you for watching. My name is Stockoglaws. This is Euro Truck Simulator 2. I hope to speak to you very, very soon. Take care. See you soon. Ciao for now.